Hello, today we're going to see that how Power Pivot works in Excel. Traditionally, we use VLOOKUP, XLOOKUP and Index and Match to bring in the data from one table to another table, but we don't need these lookup functions once we know Power Pivot. Power Pivot in the pivot tables connect the two tables and then it makes it very easy for you to get the data between the two tables. This makes your reporting more dynamic as compared to the lookup functions. So let's move towards our tutorial and see how it all works. This is Mir Salan and you're watching Growth Mindset. Once we are in our Excel sheet, we need to see that how we can activate the Power Pivot option. We click on File and here we go in Options, click on Add-ins, and here it says Microsoft Power Pivot for Excel. The type is COM Add-ins. We click over here in Manage and select COM Add-ins. Press go and here it gives us option Microsoft Power Pivot for Excel. I check mark this box, press OK, and here we can see that we have Power Pivot option appearing, which was not appearing previously. If we want to go in the Power Pivot window, we can click over here and we can access the Power Pivot window, or we can go in the data tab. And here in Data Tools, we have this option from where we can access the Power Pivot window. Let's explore further that how the Power Pivot works. I have these two tables appearing over here. One is the price table. If I go in the Design tab, here I have named this as the price table. And this table is the quantity table. Again, I go into Design and we can see that it has been named quantity table. You can change the name to whatever name you want to change. So this table contains the item code, product name and the price. And this second table contains the item code, quantity sold and the dates. It doesn't contain any product name. So how we can bring in the product name and quantity together without using the lookup formulas? For example, we usually use traditionally the VLOOKUP, XLOOKUP or Index and Match functions to bring in the data on the basis of the lookup value that is going to be the item code in both of the tables. We will be using four different techniques to pull in the data into our Power Pivot model and work on it. So let's explore further. Now we are going to move towards our first technique, and that how we can link both of the tables. We go in the data tab and over here in the data tools, we have an option of relationships. It says create or edit relationships between tables to show related data from different tables on the same report. I click on this, it opens up the dialog box. I click on new. For building a relationship, it says pick the tables and columns you want to use for this relationship. Now we have to connect two tables, so we are going to select the first table, which will contain the foreign key, and we have the related table, which is going to contain the primary key. In simple words, the primary key is going to be this item code appearing in the price table, because these are unique codes and none of the code is repeating more than once. The second table, that is the quantity table, is going to be the foreign key. The item code over here is going to be the foreign key. Each of the item code is appearing either once or more than once. So it has the duplicates in table 2, whereas in the primary table, that is the price table, we don't have any duplicates for the item codes. So let's connect both of the tables. Our first table is going to be the quantity table. I click over here. This is the quantity table. And the foreign key is going to be the item code. This is the foreign key. I repeat again, the item codes are appearing more than once and we can have the duplicates in this column. Now the related table is going to be the first table, that is a price table, and the related primary key is going to be the item code. This is primary key, this is the unique code column, and none of the codes are duplicate. So now I will press OK. And it has made a relationship. I just close it. Now we are going to go in the insert, and as we create the pivot tables, I click on the pivot table, and here it says use this workbook's data model, because we have connected both of the tables and made a relationship. So we have a data model, which we are going to see later, that how we can see that whether we have a data model or not. So for now, I click on this and I want my pivot table in this sheet. So I will just click over here and I press OK. Now here I can see that I have both of the tables appearing. That is the price table, which is the first table over here, and the quantity table, which is over here. So we will be pulling in the data from both of the tables, as both of the tables are connected. So I want the name from this table. I click on the product name, and I want the quantity sold from this table, that is quantity table. So I click on the quantity sold, and here I see that it has pulled in the data from two different tables and connected them together. Now how these tables are connected, we are going to go in the Power Pivot tab, and here I will click on manage. And once in Power Pivot window, we can see that we have the quantity table and the price table, which we added while creating the relationship. Exploring further, we have three tabs over here: home, design, and advanced. So we will be exploring a few of the features over here. If you want to view the diagram view of our model that we have created, we can click over here, the diagram view. And now it shows that the price table is connected to the quantity table. If I keep my cursor over here, we can see that the item code on both of the tables are highlighted. It shows that these both tables are connected through item code. And here we can see that it has written one over here, and we have a asterisk sign over here. So it shows that we have one to many relationship over here. One is the unique item code that does not contain any duplicates, and many shows that it has item code which are repeating and it can contain the duplicates. So it has one to many relationships. Moving back towards our Excel sheet, now we are going to move towards the second option and see that how we can add the data table to our data model. I will simply go in insert, click on pivot, and here the table range is the quantity table, and here it gives me further option, add this data to the data model. I click over here. If I press OK, only one of the table is going to get active in the Power Pivot window, and later on we are going to have to add the price table to our data model. So we're going to see that how this works. Before that, I will want to have my pivot table on the same sheet. I press OK, and now if I go in the Power Pivot, I click on the manage, we can see that we have only one table appearing over here. Once we are back in our Excel sheet, we can see that we have this quantity table as an active table in the data model. But if I click over here in all, we have the price tables and the quantity tables appearing over here. But both of the tables are not connected, so it is not going to give you any proper results. Let's see, as we performed in our last example, we had product names and we had the quantity sold. Here we can see, because we don't have any connection, so it is giving 4,320 for each of the row. But at the same time, it is giving me an option to create the relationship. We can either create the relationship or it can auto detect. Once I click on the auto detect, you need to see over here that it will change automatically after creating the relationship. So I click over here, and now it says relationship detection done, one new relationship created. I close this, and here you can see that it has automatically distributed the data and made the connections. Now once again I go in the Power Pivot window, and here I can see previously the price table was not appearing before, and now it is appearing. Again, if I go in the diagram view, we can see that both of the tables have been connected with one too many relationships, and it has detected the relationship automatically. I have reset the table to make the connection using a third option. We go in the Power Pivot. While I am on one of the tables, I can click over here, add to data model. I click over here, and here it adds the quantity table. I again go in my Excel sheet, and now I want the price table. I again go in the Power Pivot, and again I click on add to model, and I have both of my tables appearing over here. Now how I can make the connection between them, I go in the diagram view, Now I have both of my tables appearing over here, price table and quantity table, but we can see that these tables are not connected as we saw earlier. And again, as a reminder, price table item code is going to be the primary key because each of the item code is a unique code and each code is not appearing more than once, whereas the quantity table contains the item code which is going to act as a foreign key which has duplicates in it. So for connecting both of the tables, I will just click on the price table and drag it and connect it to the item code in the quantity table, release it, and now we can see that we have one to many relationship as we saw earlier. So I go back in my Excel sheet. Now both of the tables are connected. Again, I go in the insert pivot table existing sheet, click over here, use this workbook's data model. I click on this, press OK. Before that, I just give the destination and press OK. And here, once again, we have an option. I will go with the same example to make it more easy for you to understand. So it is giving us the proper results. And in fourth option, if you want to add the data to our Power Pivot data model, we can just go in the Power Pivot window. And over here, we can see that it has different options in Home tab. If you want to connect through database, so we can click for any options from here. From data services, we can click over here. If we have any Excel file in our computer and we want to fetch that file into our Power Pivot data model, so we can click on from other sources. So I click onto this. And here it gives me further options. If I just scroll down to the end, it says Excel file. I can click over here, press on next, browse from my computer and pull in the file from my computer. Now we are going to see that how we can add the calculated columns. If I'm going to do any calculation in this column, this is going to be a calculated column. For example, if I want to do any calculation, I right click, insert column, and it states calculated column 1. I can click over here and I can change the name. For example, if I want to bring in the price from the price table, so I write price and press enter, and it has changed the name of the column. We are going to work in the columns, and it is not going to work as the cell reference we have in Excel. For example, if I'm going to type anything in this cell and I press enter, so it gives me an error. So we can not type in this cell. We have to type in this formula bar. After putting in equals to sign, we are going to use the simple function, and that is the related function. I want to pick the data from the price table, and from the price table I want to have the price. So I will write related, and it gives me three options because I have three columns in the price table, that is item code, price and product name. I want to select the price, so I click over here, press tab and then press enter. And as both of the tables are connected on the basis of item code, it has fetched in the data of price. For example, I want to further do some calculation on this column. I want to find the revenue. So how can I do that? For revenue, I will need to multiply the quantity sold with the price. Either I can just add another column over here and multiply both of the columns, or I can do calculation within this column. So I will be doing the calculation within this column. I click over here, and now I go in the formula bar, use the multiplication sign, and then I want this quantity sold, so I can click on this column over here, and it has brought in the quantity sold. I will just press enter, and here I can see that it has multiplied the quantity sold with the prices. I can change the name of the column to the revenue. I go back in my Excel sheet, and here we can see that we have a revenue column. I just remove the quantity sold, bring in the revenue, and here I can see that it is showing me all of the revenue that we have made calculations there. If I want to make any changes in the formatting of these numerics, so we can go back in the Power Pivot window And here, while being in any one of the cell, I can click over here. And if I go back on my Excel sheet, so I can see that now it has a separator of a comma, which didn't had before. So whatever formatting we are going to do in the Power Pivot window, it is going to get reflected in the Excel worksheet. We can simply press Ctrl S, or we can click over here to save our data both in the Power Pivot window and in Excel sheet. Lastly, we will be working with the measures. Previously, while calculating the revenue column, we used the calculated column approach, and now we will be using the measure. For that example, I will be calculating the average price of each product sold, and we're going to see that how the calculated column does not work well, whereas creating the measures bring in more accurate results. So I create a calculated column for the average price, and I name it calculated column CC. Here I just divide the revenue column with the quantity sold column, and I press enter. And here I have the average prices in the calculated column. Now I will be creating the measure and name it average price measure. I put a colon and then an equals to, and now I begin my formula. I want the sum of this column. So I write quantity and sum of revenue divided by, again, this is the quantity table, and I want the sum of quantity sold. And now I press enter. Now let's move towards our Excel sheet and see the superiority of a measure over the average price calculated through the calculated column. Once I'm back here, I can see that I have a calculated column appearing over here, and with a function sign I have the average price using the measure. I uncheck mark the revenue and bring in the average price over here and the average price using the measure over here. Here we can see that it is giving sum of averages, and here it is giving the average price. I will just right click over here, go in the value field settings and make it average, press OK, and now we can see each of these items are appearing same. But if we are going to see the grand total, so the calculated column is giving 184.75 and the average price measure is giving 190.25. So for instance, if I bring in the revenue column and the quantity column, and here we can see that if I just divide the sum of the revenue with the quantity sold, so the average is 190.25. So the average price that the measure is giving is accurate as compared to the average price which the calculated column is giving. So we can see that the measures work in more efficient way as compared to the calculated column. And lastly, we can see that again, once we go in the Power Pivot, if I want this to be till two decimal places, I go over here, click over here, expand this column a bit to make it more readable. I can click over here, and now it is two decimal places. If I go back in my Excel sheet, and we can see that it has made it till two decimal places. Today we have covered the basics of the Power Pivot. This is the first video in the series of the Power Pivot, so many more videos will be coming to enhance your Power Pivot skills and make you more efficient while working with multiple tables without using the lookup formulas. Well, that's it. If you've liked the content, then make sure that you hit like, subscribe, and share your comments down below in the comment section. Your comments act as a navigation tool, so make sure that you give your comments. Thanks for joining me. See you soon. Take care and bye-bye.